I'm gonna make this quick this year. I'm raising money for Johns Hopkins Children's Center because they saved my oldest daughter's life twice, and my youngest children were in a NICU in a hospital that's affiliated with Johns Hopkins. So any amount of money that you can help me raise really means so much to me because it really, my daughters would not be here, and my son would not be here without Johns Hopkins Children's Center. So you'll find links below, and thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.
It's time for the 25th anniversary Civ extravaganza. Hey guys, how's it going? Unlike previous times where I was going through Civ, I actually have a constraint. The kids are going to be waking up sometime soon. Let's get going. So I'm making a little extra gold here, so I'm going to increase my science. And let's see, I got some aqueducts going. Some other stuff. Alright, and let me load up. My little cheat sheet. So as civs start finishing their tasks, I remember what it is I wanted them to do. Wait, I definitely need to take this city over here. Guys are all over the freaking place. That's the one thing I do like about, I think maybe Civ 4 started it, where you've got people have to ask permission to go through your borders. Alright. Let's clear some of this wetlands. That was not a good goody hood to get. Alright, so the question is, do we go for this guy? I guess we should, because we don't want to. We don't want him to end up eliminating my horses and stuff. Not really so much an ambush as I saw them and I put my guy there. I think this is still a Civ game where there's veteran status, but there isn't elite upgrades like we need here. I think I'm going to end up being able to keep that city because it's not a size 1 city, but I guess I'll just hold on to him for a little bit. just continue building roads and stuff. Get more bananas. Marketplace, I don't have to worry too much about gold and stuff. Alright. Let's see. Zoom to London. Alright. I guess I'll go here because he can work this mine for mines. Someone's territory. Alright. Chivalry is next. We get our special unit. AI in this game goes for domination victory or something, because they put their cities really close to each other. Like they're going to be using each other's resources. I'm used to like spreading my guys out a little more. Oh, nice. Thank you, Great Library, I guess. Yeah, invention sounds good. Infantry's a little bit stronger, but these guys can kind of get to the battle a little faster. Do a couple of those. York. I didn't mark what I wanted York to be. Make it a science city to round things out. Let's see, let's do a granary, marketplace first, just to pay for these things, then a library, then a courthouse, harbor, we'll leave it there. Canton is a wonder city. Any wonders they could be building? The Knights Templar. Ooh, crusaders every 5 turns. That sounds pretty cool. All right. Sure, why not? a military city. Let's do a rider. Hippo is working on Sun Tzu. After that, let's do a marketplace and a courthouse. Just, you know, corruption and whatnot. Okay. Hastings. The science city. Okay, we don't need more sciencey things yet. Let's go for an aqueduct. They're probably going to need that. Okay. Send him up here so we can make use of this horseman. I am losing a lot of gold per turn. How the heck did that happen? Probably all these units. That's okay. Oops, that's not where I want to go, Dark Nibbit. Alright, someone's gotta be using this hill over here. It's like a marketplace. Yeah, build a pipeline. Oh, man. Alright. So weird in this game that people can walk on mountains. I mean, I guess game-wise, right, it's kind of tricky, because on the one hand, I wanted to traditionally protect you, but on the other hand, Hannibal and his, you know, elephants and whatnot. Ooh, an elite horseman. That's awesome. Not just veteran, elite. After playing this game, and Civ 4, and even Civ 5, where even though roads cost money, it's not that bad. It's going to be weird playing Civ 6, where you only get roads when you have a trade route. Advisors. So we should get more luxuries. There are Polynesian tribes near Beijing. Compared to the Mayans, we have a strong, let's see, Carthage. Okay, cool. Let's kick their butts. Thank you. So, war somewhere ahead of me. That's it. Prepare for war. Bye. Alright. Hello, welcome to your stack of doom. Gun. I know. Zero gold. What a pain in the butt. Alright, let's go up towards the other city. You wait with your buddy here. I want to save the city. He's gonna attack me with warriors. That's just sad. Let's see, let's build a road here. Bring this pikeman over to protect the city. I lose my worker. Okay. Uh-oh. At least they couldn't steal any gold from me. Alright, relax. I just gotta reorient my army over here. Let's go over here so we can do some irrigation. Still disorder, huh? Let's see. Alright, let's have an entertainer. Let's have an entertainer. catapults are so much better in Civ 4 and 5. I'm just gonna go back and forth, see if I can do anything with these stupid catapults. There we go. I'm pretty sure catapults can't straight up kill people, which is annoying, but whatever. Alright, let me lower my science by one. Two. Three. Alright, now, just put a little money into the treasury for a minute. I have to go get stuff ready to take care of the kids, so I will see you next time. This has been Eric playing Civ 3. Bye. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you want to see more of my videos, be sure to click the subscribe button. I also enjoy comments, so feel free to leave one below. I have a pretty eclectic channel. So here on the right, you'll see a selection of other videos you might enjoy.